In about 2 or 3 hours, rain gonna fall down, so I'll be quick and fast and I'll show you the best of Nizhny Novgorod. As anywhere in Russia, you will see the statue of Lenin, the guy who killed the Tsar and built up the USSR. Now is the May and the winter has just finished recently. In March and April, all the snow has melted. And what's happened is the water has went up. And if you can see the trees over there, they're actually not the island, but they're in the water, like in the Amazon forest in the rain season. Water increased so much that it even sinked some parts of the pedestrian pathway. American boy, American boy. Alexander Nevsky Cathedral, and it's not the very touristic surroundings with some fences and repairs works and the maintenance works going on all around that area. But there is the tourist bus has just arrived to the church. The Russian language is complicated, but the old Russian language is even more complicated. But can I read it? Святейшего Кирилла Патриарха Московского. I didn't go inside the cathedral because I'm in a rush to show you more stuff. I don't have much time today and the weather hopefully gonna be okay. Today is the rehearsal of the victory parade and the streets of Nizhny Novgorod being blocked from traffic. So this is the Alexander Nevsky Cathedral. And this is the all the building site around it. Nizhny Novgorod is the very old Russian town and it has a profitable location. It's in the place where two rivers are merging, Oka River and Volga River, which is bigger. And what other thing that makes Novgorod special and interesting is it's on the hills. The town, it has the low level and the high level on the hill. Look at the bridge. On the bridge you'll see that the graffiti has been leveled up with water. This is a proof that the water has grown significantly. Nizhny Novgorod will bring me such mixed feelings. Very urban with that bridges and the graffitis. I love the urban feel in any city. And secondly, this is the very old ancient historical town in Russia. I like that building with the mosaic on it. This is how the Russian ambulance looks like. Even so, it's pissing down. I've been lucky because today all the traffic been blocked in the city and it makes that magical feel to the town. All that area which is just next to the boat station is quite well developed with restaurants, cafes, hotels, with some churches and the historical oldish buildings. Novgorod has one of the first tramways in Russia. Solution how the public space is being used for the people's entertainment. Karaoke, dance bars, cocktail bars and restaurants are all concentrated on that street by the river. And then on this building you can see a very successful example how the developers used the exterior to highlight the placement of the shops inside. Exactly what they did is they put the name of the shop in the pre-revolutionary historical way. The Kremlin in Novgorod is one of the largest in Russia. In the preparation to the town jubilee, many parts of the city has been renovated and the entry to them is closed. The pretty part of the city became something unpretty. The embankment is rather wide in Novgorod. This is the absolutely good spot for evening or morning stroll. I like the fact that there along the embankment the bench is being installed, which makes visiting of this place more enjoyable. Here we go, guys, we are arriving to one of the longest staircases in the entire Russia and it's being renovated and we won't be able to use it. all the Russian cities, the bear is the symbol of that town. But not for the Novgorod. For Novgorod is the deer. I got up to the hill next to the Kremlin. The Kremlin is nothing but the fortress. And it's not only in Moscow, it's many Russian cities, including Novgorod. And indeed, in Novgorod, the Kremlin is one of the largest in Russia. Bad news, guys. The territory of Kremlin is closed. It's closed for visitors due to renovation. This is very frustrating. Considering the fact that many sites of Novgorod is closed, I recommend you guys to come here only after all the renovation works will be finished. And this should be finished by the jubilee of the city. The Kremlin in Novgorod will be open in August 2021. We are on the Bolshaya Pokrovskaya Street, which leads from the Novgorod Kremlin toward the hill. And the entire street is pedestrian, and it consists of many restaurants and many places to eat and shopping, to buy your souvenirs, gold, or maybe some Orthodox books, and maybe cosmetic from Belarus. I got off to one of the yards, and here is a completely different Novgorod, with graffitis, with the building series not really polished, and with broken windows. That's how life in the Yurts of Novgorod is. I walked away from the pedestrian street and the very touristic, very central area of Novgorod. There is already more modern buildings here, like that shopping mall. Still, some coffee shops and restaurants are all around here, so the eating in Novgorod is not the problem. The rain is getting stronger and I'm coming closer to the suburban areas. Actually, I'm quite surprised. I didn't expect it. The more further away I'm going from the city center, the buildings becoming less and less smart, and they're kind of older and almost broken. This is quite the opposite to the smaller cities where I've been before, Vladimir and Kostroma. In the abundance of the Orthodox churches, still can find objects of other religions. The means of public transportation, very unusual for Russian cities. This is one of the longest cable cars in Russia. It goes across Volga from Nizhny Novgorod to another town on the opposite bank. Здравствуйте, один, пожалуйста. I got my ticket, it cost 100 rubles. The rain is getting stronger, so this is the perfect way of spend money in the city. And not only for me, but other people too. It's so crowded here. There's not much to see in rain because of the fog and the water drops on the glass. Didn't really impress me much. But there is a cafe. I'm in the other side of the river. This is the little town Borok. And here I'm finishing the journey through Nizhny Novgorod, the town, one of the largest in Russia. And it's located just 4 hours journey by train, 400 kilometers. There are frequent train express between two cities. And if I like the city, I mean, I probably would like it better if the weather would be sunny, but it's out of my control. Zone. Whatever it is, rain was down, but I was walking and it's not bad. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, then hit the like button and watch some other of my videos, because I traveled quite a lot within Russia and visited many cities. Scroll my channel and subscribe to it. I will appreciate it. And comment which city I should go next, or what video I should film about the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.